Hello, I'm Mike, and today I'm going to show you how to change the HTML font color. When it comes to customizing your site, font color often gets overlooked. In most cases, website owners leave the default font color to black or whatever their theme styles have defined for the body and heading text color. Changing the HTML font color might seem daunting, but it's pretty simple. In this video, we'll show you different ways to change the color of your website fonts, as well as discuss why you'd want to do it in the first place. But before we get too far, I want to let you know that there'll be links to more resources in the video's description below. And remember, subscribe and ring that bell to get notifications for future helpful content. Now, let's go over the ways that we can define color. There are several ways to define color in web design, including name, RGB values, hex codes, and HSL values. Color names are the easiest way to define a color in your CSS styles. The color name refers to the specific name for the HTML color. Currently, there are 140 color names supported, and you can use any of those colors in your styles. For example, you can use blue to set the color for an individual element to blue. However, the downside of this approach is that not all color names are supported. In other words, if you use a color that's not on the list of supported colors, you won't be able to use it in your design by its color name. Next up, we have the RGB and RGBA values. The RGB stands for red, green, and blue. It defines a color by mixing red, green, and blue values, similarly to how you'd mix a color on an actual palette. The RGB value looks like this. The first number specifies the red color input. The second specifies the green color input. And the third specifies, you guessed it, the blue color input. The value of each color input can range between 0 and 255, where 0 means the color is not present at all, and 255 means that that particular color is at its maximum intensity. The RGBA value adds one more value to the mix, and that's the alpha value, which represents the opacity. It ranges from 0, not transparent, to 1, fully transparent. The hex color codes work similarly to RGB codes. They consist of numbers from 0 to 9 and letters from A to F. The hex code looks like this. The first two numbers specify the intensity of the red color. The middle two numbers specify the intensity of the green color, and the last two set the intensity of the blue color. Another way to define colors in HTML is to use HSL values. HSL stands for hue, saturation, and lightness. Hue uses degrees from 0 to 360. On a standard color wheel, red is around 0 and 360, green is at 120, and blue is at 240. Saturation uses percentages to define how saturated the color is. 0 represents black and white, and 100 represents the full color. Lastly, lightness uses percentages similarly to saturation. In this case, 0% represents black, and 100% represents white. HSL, like RGB, supports opacacity. In that case, you'd use the HSLA value, where A stands for alpha and is defined in a number from 0 to 1. If we wanted to lower the opacity of the example purple, we'd use this code. Now that you know how to define color, let's look at different ways to change the HTML font color. Before HTML5 was introduced and set as the coding standard, you could change the font color using font tags. More specifically, you'd use the font tag with the color attribute to set the text color. The color was specified either with its name or with its hex code. Here's an example of how this code looked with hex color code. And this is how you could set the text color to purple using the color name. However, the font tag is deprecated in HTML5 and is no longer used. Changing the font color is a design decision, and design is not the primary purpose of HTML. Therefore, it makes sense that the font tags are no longer supported in HTML5. So, if the font tag is no longer supported, how do you change the HTML font color? The answer is with CSS. To change the HTML font color with CSS, you'll use the CSS color property paired with the appropriate selector. CSS lets you use color names, RGB, hex, and HSL values to specify the color. There are three ways to use CSS to change the font color. Inline CSS is added directly to your HTML file. You use the HTML tag, such as the paragraph tag, and then style it with the CSS color property, like so. If you want to use a hex value, your code will look like this. If you're going to use the RGB value, you'll write it like this. Lastly, using the HSL values, your code would look like this. These examples we've gone over show you how to change the color of a paragraph on your website. But you're not limited to paragraphs alone. You can change the font color of your headings and links as well. For example, replacing the paragraph tag with the heading 2 tag will change the color of that heading text, while replacing it with the A tag will change the color of that link. You can also use the span element to color any amount of text. If you want to change the background color of the entire paragraph or a heading, it's very similar to how you change the font color. You'd have to use the background color attribute instead and use either the color name, hex, RGB, or HSL values to set the color. Embedded CSS is within the style tags and placed in between the head tags of your HTML document. The code will look like this if you want to use the color name. The code above will change the color of every paragraph on the page to purple. Similar to the inline CSS method, you can use different selectors to change the font color of your headings and links. If you want to use the hex code, here's how that code would look. This following example uses the RBGA values so you can see how you can set the opacity of a color. And the HSL code would look like this. Lastly, you can use external CSS to change the font color on your website. External CSS is CSS that's placed in a separate stylesheet file, usually called style.css or stylesheet.css. This stylesheet is responsible for all the styles on your site and specifies the font colors and font sizes, margins, paddings, font families, background colors, and more. In short, the stylesheet is responsible for how your site looks visually. To change the font color with external CSS, you'd use selectors to style the parts of HTML you want. For example, this code will change all body text on your site. Remember, you can use RGB, hex, and HSL values, and not just the color names to change the font color. If you want to edit the style sheet, it's recommended to do so in a code editor. So now you know how you can use CSS to change the font color, but which method should you use? If you use the inline CSS code, you'll add it directly into your HTML file. Generally speaking, this method is suitable for quick fixes. If you want to change the color of one specific paragraph or heading on a single page, this method is the fastest and the least complicated way to do it. However, inline styles can make the size of your HTML file bigger. The bigger your HTML file is, the longer it will take your website to load. In addition to that, inline CSS can make your HTML messy. As such, the inline method of using CSS to change the HTML font color is generally discouraged. Embedded CSS is placed between the head tags and within the style tags. Like inline CSS, it's good for quick fixes and overriding the styles specified in an external style sheet. One notable distinction between inline and embedded styles is that they will apply to any page that the head tags are loaded on, while inline styles apply only to the specific page they're on, typically the element they're targeting on that page. The last method, external CSS, uses a dedicated style sheet to define your visual styles. Generally speaking, it's best to use an external style sheet to keep all of your styles in a single place from where they are easy to edit. This also separates presentation and design, so the code is easy to manage and maintain. Keep in mind that inline and embedded styles can override styles set in the external style sheet. The two primary methods of changing the HTML font colors are to use the font tag or CSS styles. Both of these methods have their pros and cons. The HTML font tag is easy to use, so that's a pro in its favor. Typically speaking, CSS is more complicated and takes longer to learn than typing out the HTML code. If you have an older website that isn't using HTML5, then the font tag is a viable method of changing the font color. Even though the font tag is easy to use, you shouldn't use it if your website uses HTML. As mentioned earlier, the font tag was depreciated with HTML5. Using depreciated code should be avoided as browsers could stop supporting it at any time. This can lead to your website breaking and not functioning correctly, or worse, not displaying at all for your visitors. CSS, like the font tag, has its pros and cons. The most significant advantage of using CSS is that it's the proper way to change font color and specify all the other styles for your website. As mentioned earlier, it separates presentation from design, which makes your code easier to manage and maintain. On the downside, CSS and HTML5 can take time to learn and write properly compared to the old way of writing code. Keep in mind that with CSS, you have different ways of changing the font color, and each of those methods has its own sets of pros and cons, as discussed earlier. Now that you know how to change the HTML font color, here are a few tips that will help you out. Instead of picking colors randomly, use color pickers to select the right colors. The benefit of a color picker is that it will give you the color name and the correct hex, RGB, and HSL values that you need to use in your code. Dark text with dark background as well as light text with light background doesn't work well together. They will make the text on your site hard to read. However, you can use a contrast checker to ensure that your site's colors are accessible and that the text is easy to read. If you see a color that you like on a website, you can inspect the code to get the color's hex, RGB, or HSL value. In Chrome, all you have to do is point your cursor to the part of the webpage you want to inspect, right-click, and then select Inspect. This will open up the code inspection panel where you can see a website's HTML code and the corresponding styles. What are your thoughts on changing the font color with CSS in the font tag? Let us know in the comment section below. Looking for a quality local development solution? With Dev Kinsta, in a single click, you can design, develop, and deploy new WordPress projects from your local machine. Plus, it's 100% free to use, even if you aren't a Kinsta customer. Download it today at kinsta.com/devkinsta. Thank you so much for watching. If you found this video helpful, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell for more tutorials, explainers, and helpful content like this.